All right, what's up everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It's been a long time since I made a video. Quick update. You guys know I was selling everything. I bought a couple things and I sold everything. And as luck would have it, or as the season would be, it's fall right now. And the random people that like follow me once, they reached out and said, hey, would you mind taking some portraits? Whether it's senior portraits, family portraits, dog portraits, just some portraits of my family. And I didn't have a camera. I had my Ricoh GR. It's the only camera I haven't sold. I have my Canon 8E1. That was it. And you guys might be asking what happened to the Nikon D780. Just a quick update on that. The battery hold down, the little spring that I had, it just broke. It just broke. So I called B&H and I said, hey, do you guys mind if you send me a replacement for this? And the problem was, is remember I bought a used one with no shutter count on it. It was like $500 or $600 less than what they go for new. They didn't have any used ones and they wouldn't honor the pricing, which isn't their fault. It is used, so that's, I'm not blaming them. Long story short, I ended up sending it back and they didn't want to repair it. They just said, hey, send it back, we'll give you your money. And I was left without a camera. I just said, ah, screw it, whatever, I'll shoot with the GR. And so I shot with the GR for a little bit. And then as it would happen, I got asked to do some jobs. So I said, ah, crap, I better pick something up. And I didn't want to spend a lot of money. So I went on the Fred Miranda forums and I ended up with this camera I'm filming you on now is the Fuji X-T2, I should say. And the lens, which is what I was more interested in, was the Zeiss Planar 32mm f1.8. So my interest in this lens is a couple things. First of all, when it was brand new, it's expensive. It's like $800 or $900, I don't know. But used, they go for $300. And I think this lens gets kind of dogged because in comparison to the Fuji offerings, it's got or had some, I guess, drawbacks. One, when it first came out, the lens did not autofocus well on Fuji cameras. Compared to the 35-1.4, the 35-1.4 is shallower for an APS-C sensor. It's very sharp, has that kind of 3D rendering. And then if you want kind of that faster autofocus, smoother, the 35F2 is a great option as well. And so the 32mm Zeiss lens kind of fell by the wayside a little bit. Now, I'll say in terms of Fuji lenses I've used, the 35-1.4, the 16-1.4, 56-1.2, the 23-1.4, the 90F2, and then the 16-55 2.8, 50-140 F2.8, and there's others in there, I think are really, really great lenses. One of my biggest complaints with Fuji is that, first of all, you edit the files in Lightroom, I think they look kind of goofy. Capture One is much better. But on top of that, like there's a look that some other lenses have that just, I don't know how to say this. Some of the Fuji glass is great, but it also is something off sometimes for me. And I kind of like those 1.4 lenses better. Anyways, nonetheless, when I had my Leica M240, I had the Zeiss 50mm f2 planar lens on there, and I really, really liked that lens and that rendering. And so then I watched, what's his name, GX Ace's video on this Zeiss 32, and kind of found out that they did some autofocus updates if you updated the firmware, and it has that planar look. And in his video, he described that this lens, you know, a lot of lens manufacturers are trying to overshoot the image circle so that you get like technically correct lenses. And I hate that look. I'm actually just, more and more, I just don't like it at all. I don't like technically perfect looking lenses. I like some of the classic lenses. I talked to you guys about the 51.4 Nikon D lens that I shot with. I like the way that rendered. And some of the lenses I like the most don't render perfectly. Like the 35-1.4 Fuji XF lens is an example of that. So anyways, long story short, I picked up this X-T2 for like $475. Shutter count supposedly is like 4,000. Getting accurate XF data off Fuji lenses is tough. And then I bought this Zeiss Planar 32mm lens for like 200 and something, maybe $300. And so in all, I had $800 setup, and then I'm shooting 5 jobs over the course of the next 5 weeks. And so I just wanted to kind of go after it. So this video is to tell you real quickly my experience with that, with this lens and this combination. But since I'm on an X-T2 and I can't see myself, let me pause the video and make sure I'm still recording. Okay, we're all good here. Also, there's a 15-minute record limit on this camera. I forgot about that, so good thing I checked. Anyways, so let's talk about the lens for a second. Real quick, we'll talk about autofocusing. I won't have a video to show what this looks like, but this lens is a little bit slow to autofocus on an X-T2. It's not nearly as snappy as the new Fujicrons. I would say it's probably somewhat similar to 35-1.4, maybe a little bit slower. It just kind of feels slower. Maybe that's the camera interface or whatever. I haven't misfocused on too many, to be honest with you, so I can't complain. It's just not as snappy, especially if you guys are using like Sony or the new Canons. Like those things you just know are laser focused. It adds a little bit of like confusion. Oh, did I get focus? Did I not? You know, if I took 10 shots or 8 in focus. And that comes down largely to the camera body. And I'll test this lens on a newer Fuji body in the future here. But let's just put it this way. It's acceptable. It's not perfect. Definitely usable. I've been shooting lots of portraits. It hasn't caused a problem for me yet. So autofocus, I would say, on the X-T2 with the latest firmwares in both the lens and the camera body are okay. So I'm not going to knock it for that. Two, let's talk about rendering for a second. This lens does have some of the classic Zeiss planar rendering to it. And what I mean by that is that it has kind of that 3D pop to it. It really does. And I would say this lens is incredibly, incredibly sharp. I've edited these photos in Capture One. I'll put some examples up here. When I zoom in on these, they're very, very sharp. As long as the camera nailed focus, which it did most of the time, it's very, very sharp. And I've been quite impressed with this. And I would even say, from a planar perspective, this has kind of that poppy color output that Zeiss is known for. And I've been really surprised and really happy with this lens so far. I've been using it, like I said, for about a week and a half, which isn't a long time, but it's been very, very good. The other thing I like is that when I'm shooting portraits, the bokeh has these kind of like specular highlights that you get in some of these classic lenses that I really, really enjoy as well. It's not the boring kind of muted color. Let me explain it this way. Everybody praises the Nikon 51.8S lens. It is a great lens, no doubt about it. Or even some of the new Sony Glass or whatever. They're fantastic lenses. But for me, they have kind of a sterile look. They just do. And this lens does not have that. In fact, I really am a big fan of this. I'd be hard-pressed to choose between this lens and the 35 f1.4. The f1.4 is faster, so you can get a little shallower and kind of get that. And it does have kind of this fall off effect, but the Zeiss lens has its own characteristics that are unique in its own, and they're it's fantastic as well. So in saying that, I think this lens is awesome. I like the bokeh, I like the sharpness, I like the 3D rendering, the color and contrast and pop. It gives a little different color output to the Fuji kind of look. I think this is a highly underrated lens compared to, you know, for $300, I mean, used, you can't go wrong. It's got me wondering, what about the 12mm f2.8, the brother to this lens or the sister to this lens for video? That'd be interesting. It should also be noted, guys, for video, if you want to talk video, this is the first video I've shot with this lens, and I'm shooting on it right now. Again, on an X-T2, face autofocus, eye autofocus, if it's getting it through this hat, continuous autofocus. And I was doing a little bit of autofocus testing before this video started. I'll put that up here right now. And it did okay. It did okay. All right, test 1-2, test 1-2. This is a test with the Fuji X-T2. Autofocus test. Let's see. Keeping me in focus. How fast does it move? Oh! That's what you get for not having a tripod. Not too bad. I mean, if I focus, not too bad. So anyways, guys, here's the long story short. I think this lens is great. If you like the Zeiss planar look, this lens has some of those characteristics and qualities. It's a good lens. It's not too big. It's not the smallest lens. It's got an aperture ring. It's kind of got this rubber feel to it, so a little different tactile feel than the Fuji lenses. Huge lens hood. I don't know. I'll put pictures up as I go along this. Give it a try. And I think for video, it's been okay as well. I'll put some photos up of some of the people I've shot over the last week or two with this lens. Again, these are edited myself in Capture One, so Tell me what you guys think. Flare control's great. You guys will see that here. Anyways, here's some music. Here's some photos. Thanks for watching. What do you guys think? Do you have the 32 millimeter? Do you like it? Do you not? Is it better on the newer bodies in terms of focus? I don't know. Let me know, guys. I appreciate you watching. More to come in the channel as time goes on. I got a bunch of stuff I'm doing here. So see you guys in the future. Peace.